Hacking is an increasing concern in the 21st century, which can lead to grave consequences if the sensitive information falls in the wrong hands. Here are some of the most insane hacking stories ever from around the world where hackers have done unbelievable things. Number 1. A 15-year-old hacker, Jonathan James, made NASA shut down its network for 3 entire weeks to investigate this breach. He had hacked into NASA's network to download source code equaling the value of $1.7 million to learn how the International Space Station worked. Jonathan Joseph James, a hacker, was only 15 when he hacked into the system of NASA and the United States Department of Defense along with some private companies and schools in June 1999. A native of Miami who operated under the nickname of Comrade stole data worth $1.7 million from 13 computers at NASA. NASA had to shut down its network for 21 days to investigate the breach that cost them an additional $41,000. He also became the first person in the world to crack into the network of DoD's Defense Threat Reduction Agency, which is a division responsible for analyzing possible threats to the United States. He intercepted 3,000 messages that gave him access to usernames and passwords of several employees that also gave him access to 10 military computers. Number 2. Caught with over 100 cell phone clone codes and several cloned cell phones. Hacker Kevin Mitnick was kept in solitary confinement for 8 months because law enforcement officer told a judge that he could start a nuclear war by whistling into a payphone. Kevin David Mitnick was a controversial hacker who was arrested in 1995 and sentenced to 5 years in prison for computer and communication related crimes. His trial, arrest and pursuit were all such high profile that they created a lot of media buzz. He gained unauthorized access for the first time into a computer at the age of 16 in 1979 after a friend gave him the phone number for R, the computer system used by Digital Equipment Corporation. He was arrested for this in 1988 for 12 months followed by 3 years in a supervised release. But Mitnick hacked into another computer system before the supervised release ended and went into hiding. He used cloned cell phones to hide his real location and stole valuable software from the United States' largest cell phone companies. He also read private emails of many people. When arrested, he was found with more than 100 cell phones, clone codes and several cloned cell phones along with false identification documents. Number 3. Using his knowledge of telephone systems, Kevin Paulson hacked the phone lines of a radio station to become the winner caller for a brand new Porsche. He was called the Hannibal Lecter of computer crimes by the media. A former black hat hacker, Kevin Paulson is infamous for the hacking stunt that he did on June 1, 1990. Now a 52-year-old journalist, Paulson hacked into the telephone lines of Los Angeles radio station KIIS-FM to make sure that he was the 102nd caller to win the prize of a Porsche 944S2. When the Federal Bureau of Investigation learned about his trick, they pursued him and he went underground. He was later found, arrested and went to prison for 5 years. He was the first American ever to be released from the prison with a ban on the use of computer for 3 years. When he was featured on the NBC Unsolved Mysteries, the phone lines of the show mysteriously crashed. Number 4. Your security system is crap. I am solo. I will continue to disrupt at the highest levels, was a message hacker Gary McKinnon left on 97 American military and NASA server after he managed to delete sensitive data and software on them. The US government had to spend over $700,000 to recover it. One of the most notorious hackers in history, Gary McKinnon was the brain behind the biggest military computer hackers of all time. He said that he hacked into 97 American military and NASA servers to find evidence for UFO. He hacked into these systems over a 13-month period from his girlfriend's aunt's house in London under the name of Solo. The critical files he deleted from the computer made the United States Army Military District network of 2,000 computers shut down for 24 hours. He was charged with 7 counts of computer-related crimes that each came with a 10-year sentence. Number 5. Xbox Underground, an international hacker group boasted of having broken into every game company network. They repeatedly broke into Microsoft network and stole credentials to walk into its headquarters at Redmond. They took 3 Xbox One development kits with them, which were unreleased then. Xbox Underground broke into Microsoft computer network and spent hundreds of hours copying login credentials, source code and other data between 2011 and 2013. Using these credentials, they carried out theft of the development kits of the unreleased Xbox One console from Microsoft's Redmond headquarters, driven by curiosity. The hacker group also breached the network of Zombie Studios and gained access to the simulator software for the United States military Apache helicopter. Number 6. Higinio Ochoa, a hacker who went by the codename Warmer, had a modus operandi of leaving behind the image of a woman in bikini with message as his trademark. When he hacked into an FBI criminal database, the image he left behind had GPS coordinates that led them to him. This hacker got into hacking as a child. But when the Occupy Wall Street movement began in 2011, his agenda turned political. He hacked into police department's website to reveal the name of police officers who used tear gas and sticks on protesters while covering the badges on their uniform. He joined a hacking group called Cabin Crew and also got associated with Anonymous. One day, he hacked into the FBI's criminal database that was a link to another website of the Alabama Department of Public Safety to which he had gained access. He left behind his trademark image of a woman in bikini with this word. This image that was taken by his fiancée on her iPhone with the location services turned on. The FBI traced the coordinates of the exact location, discovered her identity, and later on arrested the hacker. After spending 18 months in prison and when he was going out on a parole in 2015, his parole terms had been modified and he was told that he could not use the internet and not even touch a device that was connected to the internet. Number 7. Only using photographs of the German defense minister, a hacker, Jan Kressler, was able to recreate his fingerprints, the same person within 24 hours of the release of iPhone 5S, defeated Apple's thumbprint verification. Starbug, whose real name is Jan Kressler, used a communicational software called Verifinger and several photographs of the German defense minister to recreate her fingerprint. One of these photos taken by him from 3 meters away so that he could reverse engineer the fingerprint. In yet another stunt that he did in 2013, he created a dummy finger from a smudge on the screen of the newly released iPhone 5S and defeated Apple's Touch ID sensors. He created the dummy finger using wood glue and sprayable graphene and unlocked a phone registered to someone else's fingerprint. Number 8. By exploiting a minor glitch in a video poker machine, John Kane and another gambler won $500,000 when they were sued for hacking. Their lawyer argued, all these guys did is simply push a sequence of buttons that were legally entitled to push. They won the case. Two gamblers, John Kane and Andre Nestor, exploited a bug in IGT's Game King machine in the casinos of Las Vegas that enabled them to win $500,000. He was arrested at the Silverton Casino Lodge in July 2009 after the casino noticed suspicious play. His friend Andre Nestor also got arrested. When they were charged with computer and wire fraud in January 2011, the federal prosecutors alleged that they had to activate the bug through a complex system of pressing buttons, which made it a form of hacking. But the defense argued that both the men pressed the button they were legally allowed to press and were playing the rules, terming it a lucky streak, and they won the case.